The National Enterprise Corporation, which is a trading arm of the Uganda People's Defense Forces, was contracted to demolish and construct a four-storied building at a tune of 33 billion shillings at completion. However, even after the release of over 1 billion shillings to kickstart the project, construction works have not yet kicked off at the site. During an impromptu visit by the Hoima Situman Member of Parliament, Asnas Nyakato, it was revealed that not even construction materials have been delivered.
And 10 billion Ugandan shillings was allocated to upgrade, and we have been informed several times by the hospital administration that work is in progress, construction is in progress, but as you can see, there is nothing on the ground.
Why the work stopped was because the money that we had, what that we had, wasn't enough to even raise the foundation. Because when you're constructing a storage building, you can't just construct and say, leave the foundation down. It can weaken the structure that comes out. So we needed more money, which you hope in this the next financial year, it will be allocated so that the construction works can go on quickly.
Shockingly, some of the nursing mothers who deliver normally sleep on the floor, leaving the beds to those who have been operated as caretaker sit and sleep in the compound.
As people from Bunyoro, because this is a regional referral hospital, and when we talk about maternal health, where many of our women have lost lives giving birth, many of our women have lost lives, maybe their babies have lost lives when they are being delivered, it's something which you can't take for granted.
The challenge has been that the money to construct it is a big challenge. You had one billion. But that 1 billion,
which was released
and even contracted, the contractor was contracted. But the challenge is that money is not enough to construct a foundation. So the foundation needs like 3 billion. And the whole structure will take around 33 billion shillings. So we're trying to lobby to see to that you get more money so that the construction works can be shown.
Among other challenges, the hospital management has reported understaffing as a factor affecting service delivery.
What we have done as a hospital, with a little money, since we got clearance to recruit from Minister of Public Service, the little money that was supposed to go back to the treasury, we have been given clearance to recruit specialists, and we have included the radiologists in that, so that we shall be able to sort out the issue.
How much money do you charge?
The Hoima Situman Member of Parliament, Nyakato, has vowed to put the issue on the floor of Parliament as a matter of national importance. During the visit, some of the attendants, the patients, told the woman Member of Parliament that much as the services have slightly improved, there's still lack of drugs in the facility, whereby most of the drugs have to be brought from the private pharmacies in town. The services at the hospital are generally better, but the only problem is the lack of enough space to accommodate both the caretakers and the patients. Also, most of the drugs are not provided, and we end up buying them from outside of the hospital. They have prescribed medicine for my wife, who is due to be operated, but the medicines are not in the hospital. I have been told to buy them, yet I don't have any money. So I request government to help and restock drugs in the hospital. The new structure, after completion, will contain a maternity ward, gynecology, neonatal and postnatal services, a theatre, a morgue, among others. Report compiled by Godfrey Mohomoza for the news.